this day, we take this opportunity to thank you for all the privileges of being in the body of Christ. We have come together to join this couple as you establish the foundation of their lives together by the power of your word and your spirit. We welcome the presence of the Holy Spirit into this place, and we give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. And we thank you for bringing us into agreement with you as you supernaturally join these two lives to become one flesh.
Waking up in the morning, gotta thank God.
Good day, good day. It's gonna be a good day, good day. A good day, good day. Yeah.
Just waking up in the morning, gotta thank God.
A good day, good day. It's gonna be a good day, good day.
Yeah. Like to the music, we in all black.
The sun just said hola, I enter mi casa. Don't mind no I do not need nada. The joy got me so high, my feet. On cha-cha, and this song is my song. Dum dee dum dum da da, it's nada.
Take the say, I'm skating on the freeway. On the freeway, radio's acting like my DJ.
Like my DJ,
eating with like all my favorite guys. Waiter still ain't brought my fries. I ain't tripping off the delay.
Off the delay,
your loving got my spirit shouting hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Edges hit my skin and ask me how you doing.
Hello,
trees are moving, swaying to the music. You're the sky speaking beautifully, and honestly, it's kind of fluent.
Well,
no haters, my mind and my savior. No Wi-Fi on my i5, but see, I'm mildly favored.
Yeah.
Give a wide smile to my neighbors, and I'm high-fiving these strangers.
Strangers.
And I like life, so I shine bright and like tie-dye on these gray shirts.
Today is a good day, a good day, a good day.
Say what? Say what?
Today is a good day,
yeah.
A good day, a good day.
Make it clear,
Shawty. Today was a good day.
Today is a good day.
Let them know.
A good day, a good day. A good day, a good
yeah.
day. Today is a good day.
What?
A good day, a good day.
Today was
I'm
a good day.
I'm finally happy. I'm finally free, yeah. I'm finally liking how it feels inside to be me. No need for a compliment to make me feel good, I already know. I feel you're alive, and it's alright to be alright. Yeah,
today was a good day.
Today is a good day.
Oh, yeah. Oh, today was a good day.
Today is a good day. A good day.
Oh, yeah. Today was a good day.
keep my eyes off of you.
without you now. I can't quite figure out. Everything she does is beautiful. Everything she does is right. Cause it's you and me and all other people. Nothing to do, nothing to lose. And it's you and me and all other people. And I don't know why I can't keep my eyes up from you and me and all other people. Nothing to do, nothing to prove. And it's you and me and all other people. And I don't know why I can't keep my eyes off of you. And in what month this clock never seems so alive.
Saying to my friends, There is my future wife, and then I took the step to meet someone who would change my life. It had to be my destiny, 'cause I was made to love you, my hands to touch you, my arms to hold you, my legs to stand, my time to spend with you forever. I was made to love you, my lips to kiss you, my eyes to see you, my legs to stand, my time to spend with you forever and ever. First break up and make up that got us to this moment. And every girl,
who gives this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
Take your bride and step forward, Jerry. We have some balloons on the front row that are going to be released in memory of Carlene Crawford, Jacqueline Tucker, and Tanisha Tucker. Each of these women have instilled in Tamresa the qualities of a virtuous woman so that she can become the godly woman that she is destined to be in her marriage to Jared. Their memories will live on forever. Would you please pray with me? Father, as we come before you this day, we take this opportunity to thank you for all the privileges of being in the body of Christ. We have come together to join this couple as you establish the foundation of their lives together by the power of your word and your spirit. We welcome the presence of the Holy Spirit into this place, and we give you all the praise and the honor and the glory, and we thank you for bringing us into agreement with you as you supernaturally join these two lives to become one flesh. In Jesus' mighty name, and everybody said,
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated.
Thank you.
Jared and Tamresa, as I read scripture from the fifth chapter of the book of Ephesians, I want you both to pay very close attention to the words that are stated here. They are the words of God, and the Holy Spirit will always honor these words as you stand on them in faith. While the world understands that marriage is a legal contract, and we don't make light of that, at the same time, it's important to also understand that Christian marriage is a spiritual covenant with God Almighty. As two born-again believers speak the word of God in faith, the power of God is released into their lives and establishes a covenant of union that shall never be broken. From this day forward, you will have the miracle-working power of God operating in your lives as you commit yourselves to this covenant. With these thoughts in mind, listen very carefully to these words. Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even also as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, just as the church is subject to Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of water by the word, that he might present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. So husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as the Lord does the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. Jared, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior?
I have.
Tamresa, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior?
Yes, I have.
So now upon the public profession of your faith, you have made known to all men that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is your Lord and your Savior. Jesus told Peter in Matthew 16 and verse 18 that upon this rock I will build my church. This profession of faith will always be the central force of your marriage together. Because of this profession of your faith, God's word says that you will stand cleansed and forgiven from all your past. You are a new creation. Old things are passed away and all things have become new. Today you stand before your family and friends as a living testimony to the saving grace of God. When you made Jesus Christ the Lord of your life, you were joined with Him. 1 Corinthians 6:17 says that you are one spirit with Him. And here in Ephesians it says that you have become one flesh with the Lord. You are His, He is yours, and you are one together with Him. Ecclesiastes 4:12 says, though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. Jared and Tamrisa, as you keep Jesus as the third cord of your marriage, you will be able to work through every difficulty in life together, and your marriage will never be destroyed. Today, you are establishing the unconditional love of God in this union. And by this love, you will be able to overlook each other's weaknesses and grow from each other's strengths. Always remember to walk in forgiveness towards each other and never let the sun go down on your anger. I want to speak for a moment to all who have come to witness this union. Because you have been chosen as beloved family and friends, your influence must always agree with God's word. From this day forward, I charge you as friends and family to do everything in your power to see that this union remains solid, strong, happy, and prosperous. Jared and Tamrisa, the vows you are about to make will be made not just to each other, but to God. Ecclesiastes 5 and verse 5 says, it's better not to vow than to make a vow and not keep it. As you profess your vows to one another, I want you to consider the seriousness of this commitment and to speak each word in faith. Do you, Jared, take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love, honor, and to cherish, to commit yourself in helping her fulfill her part of the building up of the kingdom of God, to pray with her through every trial and circumstance, believing the best in her, and enduring all things till death do you part?
I do.
Then would you make this commitment of your faith by repeating these vows after me? I, Jared.
I, Jared.
Take Tamrisa to be my wife.
Take Tamrisa to be my wife.
To be joined with you.
To be joined with you.
In heart.
In heart.
Mind.
Mind.
And soul.
And soul.
In a love that cannot be altered.
In a love that cannot be altered.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In tempest or in trial.
In tempest or in trial.
I will give myself up for you.
I will give myself up for you.
Until the end of our days.
Until the end of our days.
You are my best friend.
You are my best friend.
The love of my life.
The love of my life.
And I promise to love you unconditionally.
And I promise to love you unconditionally.
To comfort you.
To comfort you.
To honor and respect you.
To honor and respect you.
To speak and to listen.
To speak and to listen.
To keep our marriage exciting.
To keep our marriage exciting.
To protect you.
To protect you.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
From this point forward.
From this point forward.
I determined to always look to God first.
I determined to always look to God first.
In our relationship.
In our relationship.
And to follow His wisdom for our future.
And to follow His wisdom for our future.
I will lift you up.
I will lift you up.
And cover you in prayer daily.
And cover you in prayer daily.
I determined to be the leader in our home.
I determined to be the leader in our home.
And to always stand on the Word of God.
And always stand on the Word of God.
For every decision.
For every decision.
We make together.
We make together.
I make a vow to you this day.
I make a vow to you this day.
To receive you as my own flesh.
To receive you
as my own.
To receive you as my own flesh.
To love you as Christ loves the church.
To love you as Christ loves the church.
And gave Himself for it.
And gave Himself for it.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
I give you my body.
Give you my body.
And I will be true.
And I will be true.
To all the words I say to you.
To all the words I say to you.
These things I vow to you today.
These things I vow to you today.
Until my very last breath.
Until my very last breath.
We shall forever be one.
We shall forever be one.
you, Tamresa, receive this man to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love, honor, and to cherish, to commit yourself in helping him fulfill his part of the building up of the kingdom of God, to pray with him through every trial and circumstance, believing the best in him, and enduring all things till death do you part?
Yes, I do.
Then would you make this commitment of your faith by repeating these vows after me? I, Tamresa.
I, Tamresa.
According to the word of God.
According to the word of God.
Make a vow to you this day.
Make a vow to you this day.
To submit myself to you.
To submit myself to you.
As unto the Lord.
As unto the Lord.
I will always show reverence to you.
I will always show reverence to you.
As the head of this union.
As the head of this union.
God made me from your rib.
God made me from your rib.
And he brought me to you.
And he brought me to you.
He created me to stand by your side.
He created me to stand by your side.
And to be your helpmate.
And to be your helpmate.
As we together fulfill.
As we together fulfill.
His purpose for our lives.
His purpose for our lives.
I determine to honor you.
I determine to honor you.
In all my ways.
In all my ways.
And to respect you.
And to respect you.
As you lead me and our family.
As you lead me and our family.
Jared, since you have come into my life.
Jared, since you have come into my life.
You have brought me pure happiness.
You have brought me pure happiness.
On this day.
On this day.
I vow to honor you.
I vow to honor you.
Respect you.
Respect you.
Uplift you.
Uplift you.
Care for you.
Care for you.
And to love you.
And to love you.
Through the good and the bad.
Through the good and the bad.
I vow to stand by your side through it all.
I vow to stand by your side through it all.
I will love you.
I will love you.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
And I promise to love you.
And I promise to love you.
Until death do us part.
Till death do us part.
May I have the bride's ring, please? The wedding ring is a symbol of marriage. It's a token of your faith in God and of your love for one another. This ring is made out of precious metal. It is a never-ending circle that indicates the continuing love of God, a love that never fails, never presents itself haughty or puffed up. The love of God and the faith of God is what causes his power to move in your lives together. The unending band of gold symbolizes the permanence of the vows which you are taking, which may be honorably broken only by death. Jared and Tamresa, I want you to wear these rings as a continual reminder of your faith in God and of your love for each other. As a token of your covenant, you will now give and receive the rings. Jerry, would you take the ring, place it on Tamresa's finger, and repeat this after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
It is a token of my love for you.
It's a token of my love for you.
And my faith in God.
And my faith in God.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of the unending wholeness.
As a symbol of the unending wholeness.
Love, peace, and joy.
Love, peace, and joy.
Of our new life together.
Of our new life together.
I believe with all my heart.
I believe with all my heart.
That this is forever.
This is forever.
May I have the groom's ring, please? Tamresa, would you take that ring? Place it on Jared's finger and repeat this after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
I give it as a token of my love for you.
I give it as a token of my love for you.
And my faith in God.
And my faith in God.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of the unending wholeness.
As a symbol of the unending wholeness.
Love, peace, and joy.
Love, peace, and joy.
Of our new life together.
Of our new life together.
I believe with all my heart.
I believe with all my heart.
That this is forever.
That this is forever.
Our Lord has prepared a table and bids you both come, receive of the bread of his body, and the wine of everlasting life. Is there a song? No. This is an exciting time. Are y'all doing good so far?
Yeah, we're doing good.
Okay. So, what I love about this is that this is the first time that you're going to partake of the Lord's Supper as husband and wife. Mm-hmm. And it's such an act of faith, mm-hmm. because you're demonstrating to God, your family, and your friends the fact that you're going to put Jesus first in your marriage. And you're going to glorify God and remember what he did at Calvary for both of you.
Because he went to that cross so that both of you could come into a relationship with him and with your Heavenly Father, so that you could now find and fulfill your destiny together. And you're going to be able to love each other with his love, because he's put that love in your hearts. And so I want to encourage you to receive the Lord's Supper on a regular basis to serve each other. And that's what we're going to do here in just a minute. But the Bible says, as you all know, it says that Jesus' body was broken for you so that you might be healed. And if you remember, on that last evening before Jesus went to the cross, he celebrated Passover with his disciples. And they didn't realize that he was going to be crucified in just a few hours. But he said, he took the bread and he blessed the bread and he broke the bread and he gave the bread and he said, take, eat, and do this in remembrance of me. Do this in remembrance of what I did. Never forget the grace. Never forget the sacrifice. Never forget what I did so you could be free and therefore your marriage could be free. So Jared, for the first time, would you serve your wife the bread that represents the broken body of Jesus? And for the first time, Tamarisa, would you serve your husband the bread? And we know this is not the blood of Jesus, but it represents the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is so powerful because it's the only blood that's ever been shed by a man who never sinned. It's the blood that has the power not only to save us, but it has the power to heal you. And I want to encourage you to pray for each other on a regular basis, not only for wholeness and prosperity, but for healing. If the enemy tries to come against you in your bodies, you lay hands on each other. God's given you the authority to heal each other. If your children get sick, when you have children, you can pray for them. Always go to the Lord first in prayer. We don't go to the doctors first. We don't go to the, you know, to get counseling first or whatever. No, we go to the Lord. We go to his word. So this represents the blood that was shed so that you could both be free. So for the first time, Jared, would you serve your bride the cup? All right. And Tamarisa, for the first time, serve your husband. They're going to finish the song, or we could go ahead and light the unity candle if you want to. The only thing is, the people won't hear what I have to say, so whichever way you...
I guess we can stall a little bit. We can stall a little bit.
Just enjoy the moment. You're only going to do this once.
Yeah.
And look at what a beautiful evening it is with your beautiful family and friends. And Tamarisa, you look gorgeous, by the way.
No way, yes.
And Jared... Jerry looks very handsome.
Yes, he does.
Thank you.
And I'm very proud of y'all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And I just feel the presence of the Lord in this place. I hope you do.
Yes, I do.
And, you know, we have to cultivate that presence.
Mm-hmm.
And so I want to encourage you all to cultivate the presence of God in your home.
Mm-hmm.
So that when people walk into your home, they're like, oh my gosh, God's here.
Yeah.
And he's actually Lord here. We're not going to do things here that don't glorify him.
Mm-hmm.
Everything we do, words, food, fun, it's all going to glorify him. Amen.
Amen.
And
amen.
Your kids will follow your example.
Amen.
And your friends will follow your example. And you'll be able to disciple your kids and your friends, whoever the Lord brings, because they're going to watch what you're doing. They're going to say, man, they're doing it right. Look how happy they are. And they're going to want to be like you.
Yeah. Yes.
Amen. Yes.
Why don't you face the congregation? I'll move over here.
You mean what? What do I got for them?
You know, you can come over here if you want.
What's that?
My shoe.
Baby, with the joy of you.
It's a symbol of two individuals from two different families coming together to become one flesh. Jared and Tamresa, you may now light your unity candle. Whom the Lord joins together, let no man separate. This time in our ceremony, we're going to pray a blessing over the bride and the groom. Would you join me in prayer? Lord of life and of love, would you bestow your grace upon this marriage and seal this covenant with your love? Would you sanctify this couple by your Holy Spirit, that they may give themselves fully one to the other and to you? Would you give them strength and patience to live their lives in a manner that will bring about prosperity and contentment, and that they will be an inspiration to those around them. We thank you for these blessings that we impart now in the mighty name that's above every other name, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Jared and Tamresa, here's what you've been waiting for. Since you've made these commitments before God in this assembly, according to the laws of the state of Georgia, and as a representative of Jesus Christ before Almighty God, and in the name of the Father and of His Son Jesus and the Holy Spirit, I pronounce you one flesh. You are now husband and wife. Jared, you may kiss your bride.
welcome to the reception for Tamarisa and Jared. I am going to be your MC this evening. I'm actually Tamarisa's aunt. And before we start, let's give it up for the DJ now, because y'all are going to be too busy dancing. All right, so we're going to get this party going. You guys were able to eat, and you have your dancing shoes, so we're going to do this really quick so we can start dancing. Okay? All right. So, DJ, you ready? We're going to introduce the bridal party. And actually, the bridal party is made up of a lot of special people to Jared and Tamarisa, so we want them to feel as welcome as possible. So I'm going to need you guys to make a lot of noise when they come in, because they're so excited. And we're excited to get the thing started. So let's go. Yeah. First up, we have the bridesmaid, Marlene Tucker. And she's being escorted by the groomsman, Ty Kamal. Give it up for them. Let's hear it. Let's hear it. You guys can do better than that. Let's hear it. Next up, we have the bridesmaid. So get your cameras ready. This is all of the, you know, the pictures. You want to take these pictures. DJ, first song. The first dance.
Mm-hmm. to let you know. When you're lost, when you're alone, and you can't get back again, I will find you, darling.
Next, we're going to have the uncle-niece dance. But like she said, that's her dad. So Mr. Marcel Tucker Jr. to the dance floor. Somebody have some tissue close for him, please. And they're gonna be dancing to Hero by Mariah Carey. Tissue now, because it's the mother and son dance. So we're gonna ask Jared to escort his beautiful mom to the dance floor. Give it up. Look, I have four boys. There's nothing like a mom.
that's who I am.